Understanding Portfolio Planning Concepts in Rally. Agile portfolio management is a dynamic, transparent, and decentralized process that helps product teams plan and prioritize investments, and helps engineering teams plan and organize the supporting work that delivers value to stakeholders. Rather than highly detailed, centralized plans that are budgeted and distributed, Agile plans rely on the collaboration of stakeholders at multiple levels within the organization. Agile plans include frequent adjustments that reflect changes in the market, new priorities, and new discoveries about risk and work estimates that surface during the process. Agile portfolio management helps an organization's leaders make sure that only the most valuable work is being prioritized and budgeted. And if priorities change, the process is flexible enough to change without interrupting the forward momentum. Rally enables agile portfolio management through a variety of pages that empower the planning and execution of investment priorities that are based on the reality of work at the team level. This makes it easy to steer the plan and communicate changes across the organization. To model and measure portfolio planning and execution effectively, it's essential to understand how to represent the people, timeframes, and work that support your investments. And it's important to get alignment across the organizations in the workspace on these values before starting the planning and execution work. That's because some constructs are difficult to change after work begins. So let's start with the best practices for representing your organizations and teams. In Rally, the project hierarchy is used to represent your organizations and teams. By representing your organizations correctly, this structure allows for reporting and metrics to roll up from the lowest level in the hierarchy to summary points in the organization, like at the product group or department level, where you might want to plan or monitor progress for a collection of teams. It's important to remember that even though the name for the organization hierarchy in Rally is the project hierarchy, or project picker, or we may refer to project scoping, this construct is meant to represent the groups of people that are working together on projects, products, or services. You should organize this structure according to the delivery groups that will be working together to deliver a specific product, service, or component. Because organizations can be structured in a variety of ways, bear in mind that these delivery groups and this structure in Rally might be different from your organizational structure. The structure you build here in the project hierarchy is simply a container for the work that the collection of delivery groups or teams will deliver in support of your portfolio investments. Your workspace administrator, or in some cases the project administrator for your organization, can administer all of this for you. The work for the projects and the release time boxes in which they may be delivered are represented with other Rally constructs that we'll discuss shortly. It's important to note that your portfolio delivery may depend on teams in other organizations. In this case, your organization structure may need to reflect branches for other organizations, departments, or teams that are connected at higher levels of the organization, and it may make sense for them to share the same subscription and workspace in Rally to plan and track their work. And that's okay. Rally does support dependencies across teams, trains, and even organizations when reporting the progress of work execution. If rolling up data is important, such as velocity for planning purposes at an organization or department level, and for reporting delivery against that plan velocity, it's important to create a direct hierarchical structure within the same workspace. The portfolio items hierarchy in Rally models the levels of strategic investment that your organization will deliver to customers and stakeholders over time. By default, your subscription in Rally has two levels in the portfolio hierarchy: initiative and feature. The number of levels in your portfolio and their names are all customizable. Align with other organizations in your Rally workspace to identify the number of levels that you want to model and to choose the names you want to give them. We're going to use the default names when referring to portfolio items in this training, but the names that your organization uses might be different. Some organizations only want or need to use the lowest two levels in the portfolio hierarchy because they invest at the initiative level and deliver at the feature level. The strategy and theme levels are likely more important to stakeholders at the upper levels of your organization. If they're using Rally as a portfolio management tool, then you want to keep those levels and model them, but focus your planning and execution work using the lowest two levels, and then connect your investments, which might be your initiatives, to a theme for the benefit of other stakeholders. Additionally, there's a portfolio item attribute called investment category that can be used in conjunction with any portfolio item type. If there's no need to roll up reporting to the higher levels of the portfolio hierarchy, you can remove those levels and then use the investment category to categorize your portfolio items. The investment category values that you define are shared for all types of portfolio items across the entire workspace. It's important to get this structure right from the beginning for all the stakeholders that are using the Rally workspace. You can't insert or reorder levels in the portfolio hierarchy later, but you can delete a portfolio item type if there are no associated portfolio items. Take the time to determine how many levels you'll actually use and remove any upper levels that you don't need. Whatever changes you make will apply for all organizations in the workspace. Your workspace administrator can then adjust the defaults to reflect the portfolio item types and their names that you've aligned on for each level of the portfolio item hierarchy. After this is complete, you can begin to model your portfolio by creating portfolio items of the appropriate type. Scheduling constructs are represented in Rally using the release and iteration time boxes and milestone dates. These are time spans within which portfolio items and their supporting work items can be scheduled for mid-range planning and execution. We recommend that all teams in an organization plan and execute on a common set of releases and iterations, also known as sprints, to facilitate reporting, dependency tracking, and risk management. The release time box is used for scheduling the lowest level of portfolio item, in our case features, as well as the user stories and defects that we want to complete in the release timeframe. Higher levels of portfolio items, like initiatives, aren't scheduled in a release time box, although the planned start and end dates for any type of portfolio item can be administered for tracking progress. Release time boxes are typically about 3 months long. The iteration time box is used by teams to schedule their work as represented by user stories and defects into a right-sized time frame for delivering values to stakeholders. Usually, iteration time boxes are 1 or 2 weeks long. Since these time boxes can be administered team by team, it's important to use naming conventions to make them consistent when they're administered, and also use the same start and end dates if you want to report on releases or iterations across teams. Milestones are dates that are used to track events, like deployments or deadlines, like delivery commitments or targets, like MVP or beta feature availability. Milestones are assigned a specific date, not a date range, and they can be shared across teams or across an entire workspace when applicable. Release and iteration time boxes and milestones are essential for prioritizing and planning work against capacity for delivery, and for constructing roadmaps and stakeholder communication. In preparation for release or PI planning, engineering teams collaborate to roughly identify and estimate the user stories that support the features that the product team proposed for the release. If these stories or low-level estimates aren't known at the time of planning, a t-shirt size or rough estimate can be assigned to the feature to approximate the number of points of velocity needed to deliver it within the time frame. These estimates are compared with the planned velocity for all delivery teams that will be working on the feature in the release. Comparing the work estimates for the feature with the actual capacity of the affected teams based on their availability for the release makes it easy to see when the plan will fail. But creating a predictable plan is more than just a math equation. It also needs to take into consideration risks, dependencies, and the likelihood that scope will grow as new information becomes available over time. Even if it appears the work can be completed within the release, it's a good practice to reserve a portion of the plan velocity to account for these factors. Once the features are committed for the release, the teams can plan the user stories and defects that are associated with the feature into iterations, again, leaving room for the unexpected yet certain change. At any point in time, the progress of the portfolio can be reviewed using the percent done measurements, the plan progression page, and the burn-up charts that are available in various pages and applications in Rally. Congratulations! You've tackled the important planning concepts that are vital to model, deliver, and measure your organization's portfolio execution. Now it's time to get started with creating your portfolio items in Rally. To learn more about Rally and Agile practices, check out our blog and community. We invite you to like this video and subscribe to our channel so that you never miss new content as it's added.